beach conditions look to be improving along Southwest Florida shores. The latest red tide report showed that the red tide has decreased in Lee, Charlotte, and Collier counties over the last week.
Tonight, talks of improvements are also happening between people out in the water. NBC2's Alex Howard is at Lover's Key, where the conditions didn't stop today's Floatopia.
Dozens of boaters gathered off Lover's Key on Sunday for Floatopia, a sign of improving red tide conditions. But for some boaters, this summer is one of the worst in recent memory. It's a problem that has plagued Southwest Florida beaches all summer. But on Sunday, boaters finally got a small break.
You know, trying to get some boating in with the bad water and what have you, but yeah, this is what we got. This is it.
Ed Skorak and his friends decided to take advantage of improved conditions, participating in Floatopia. While the water was still brown, swimmers weren't feeling red tide's typical effects.
And right now, look at it. You can't see down past your knee.
We've been in the water all day, every day. I haven't had any negative effects. No rash, no runny eyes, no respiratory issues. I haven't seen anything out of the ordinary.
Experts say a change of wind direction is why the air quality improved.
Over the past couple of weeks, we've really seen the concentrations go down at the beaches. And there's a good reason for that, is that we've had much more consistent winds out of the east, kind of pushing those blooms of red tide further out to sea.
Despite the improved conditions, with peak season approaching, many beaches, like here at Lover's Key, are still relatively empty.
The beaches have been more quiet, though, which is nice. I kind of feel like we're on our own private oasis.
And while some Gulf beaches have improved as much as 25% as far as red tide goes in Southwest Florida, we're not out of the woods yet. In Lover's Key, Alex Howard, NBC2.